Let's create a program to demonstrate how to declare and use variables. I'll start by making a new directory and project. I'll create this project inside of a Rust projects directory under my projects directory. At the directory location of your choosing, create a new project with cargo by running the command cargo new variables. When I run that command, I see that cargo created the binary application variables package. I will change directories to that new variables package now and open it in VS Code using the shortcut command code. Before I get started, note that I have the Rust Analyzer extension enabled. So when I'm typing, the extension will show helpful information, including errors and warnings. So we'll first focus our attention on the file source, main.rs. I'm going to go ahead and delete this print line and start declaring a new variable. So I'm going to start it with just a variable called x is equal to 1 and put a semicolon at the end of that. And then let's use the println macro to print out the value of x. And I can do it just like that and add a semicolon at the end of the line. In the next line, I'll declare a variable named y, and I can say let y is equal to true. And notice that this is a Boolean type. And then I can print the value of y right after that. So I can say here the value of y is, and then include that value of y and close this with a semicolon. So to run the program, what I want to do now is to open up the terminal and Visual Studio Code. I can either go to Terminal, New Terminal, or I can use this shortcut here as described. So once I'm at my terminal, what I want to do is enter cargo run to go ahead and compile and run my program. And what I see printed out here is the value of x is 1 and the value of y is true. Now let's see what happens when we try to change the value of x. So after printing the value of x, I'll add in two lines. The first will be to assign x a new value, say x equals 2, and then the second will be to print the value of x again. So let's go ahead and just try on line 4 to say x is equal to 2. And then we want to be able to print the value of x again. So I'll just copy that line to line 5. And there we go. So now let's save this program and run it again. Now I'll immediately notice that something is wrong here. So Rust Analyzer is telling me cannot assign twice to immutable variable x. So assuming that I were to run the program, I would see the exact same error here. So whether you're using the Rust Analyzer or not, by the time that you actually compile the program, you will get that error. So if I wanted to be able to do this, I would need to go ahead and make sure that my variable x is mutable by adding that mute keyword. And after I add that mute keyword, I can go ahead and save this. I see the error goes away on line 4. So assuming now that when I run the program again, cargo run, I can see the value of x is 1, then the value of x changes to 2, and finally our value of y printed out. So that's just a reminder about mutable variables and needing to make sure to include that mute keyword if you want to change the value of a variable after it's bound. All right, so next I want to show an example of shadowing a variable. So after this println macro line on 8, what I want to do is shadow the value of y. So I can say let y is equal to false. So now I'm setting my Boolean value of y to false. So if I were to print the value of y again, we can assume that it will now become false. So let's go ahead and run this program again with cargo run. So I can compile my latest changes and run, and I see now the last line printed out here is that the value of y does become false. So finally, what I want to do is define a constant of type string. So what I'll do is just skip a line down here, and on line 12, I'll start by defining a new constant with the keyword const, and the name of the const will be string. And what I want to do here is make this type string, and it's going to be equal to the value hello, and I'll add a semicolon at the end of that. So now I've just defined a new constant called string with a string value and assigned it a value of hello. And I do get a warning from Rust Analyzer that the constant string is never used, so I need to go ahead and print that out. So on line 13, I will add a new print statement and say the value of the string constant is, and then we want to pass in that string constant and end with a semicolon. So now let's go ahead and run the program with cargo run. And what we'll see here is one more print statement where the value of the string constant is hello. And I do notice I have a typo, so let me go ahead and fix that and save the program again. That is what I wanted to show here. Of course, you'll continue to get more practice with variables and using variables in different ways throughout the series and as you write your own programs. Now that we've explored more about how variables work in this demo, let's move on to explore data types.